Coming up, President Obama puts the kibosh on executive salaries over a half million for companies taking bailout money. Fat cats prepare to diet. Woohoo! First up, though, some underreported holy mackerel stories in today's news, beginning in Iran. Iran today said that they launched a homemade satellite into orbit. Iran's vociferous little president, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, went on state-run television and said, "Dear Iranian nation, your children have placed the first indigenous satellite into orbit. With God's help and the desire for justice and peace, the official presence of the Islamic Republic was registered in space." The BBC also quotes Ahmadinejad saying that the satellite was launched into orbit to spread, quote, monotheism, peace, and justice. So if it's a clear night where you are tonight and you see a little new mechanical moving blip in the sky, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad wants you to see that blip and think, monotheism. This is sort of a bad news, good news story, actually. The bad news is obvious. Iran wants to up its military capacity. Specifically, even if you leave aside the issue of nukes, Iran wants really long-range missiles. They say that their longest-range missiles now can go about 1,200 miles. And yes, Israel is within 1,200 miles of Tehran. But they know they would really get themselves some attention if their missiles could go even further than that, say, to the heart of Europe. In order to get their missiles to go further than 1,200 miles, the Iranians need to master the staging process. You know how in rockets there are stages? That's what they need to figure out. If they successfully put a satellite in orbit today, that might mean that Iran has mastered the staging process, which might mean that they're halfway home toward getting really long-range missiles. That is the bad news. That's why it's bad news that Iran says it launched a satellite today. The good news is that Iran lies all the time about its missiles especially. Remember last summer they said they launched a whole big mess of long-range missiles? Like today, they even released photographic proof of that missile launch. Here's the photo, in fact, that they released last summer of that supposedly very impressive, scary missile launch. Check out how this photo is totally photoshopped. They just duplicated the same missile all over the picture. Their photoshopping is worse than the North Koreans. So that is the potential silver lining to this otherwise worrying news today. The silver lining here is that they might be total BS artists. And of course, we all hope that they are. In other Iran news today, you know that the United States cut off diplomatic ties with Iran 30 years ago, right? Since the Iranian militants took dozens of Americans hostage at the U.S. Embassy in Tehran for more than a year in 1979, we have not had a working embassy there. We don't have official diplomatic relations. But in 2006, we restarted people-to-people exchanges with Iran. Not leader-to-leader, but regular civilian-to-regular civilian. Or more accurately, athlete-to-athlete. In the past couple of years, in an effort to promote U.S.-Iranian relations, we have sent 20 American wrestlers to compete in Iran, and Iran has sent about 75 water polo players and basketball players and ping-pong players, table tennis players, over here. As of today, we have also sent our national women's badminton team to Iran. And in other news, hey, we have a national women's badminton team. We have sent 8 players along with 4 coaches and managers. It's the first American-Iranian sports exchange since Obama has been president. One spot of awkwardness for this trip is that the Iranian government enforces a religious dress code for women. So women, even while playing high-level sports, are expected to cover their hair and to wear clothing that hides the shape of their bodies. As if badminton isn't hard enough already. How are America's women badminton players going to cope with that kind of physical restriction? They're not. Loophole alert. The Iranian government has decided to make the Iranian-American badminton matches women only. No male spectators will be allowed. No male spectators means no requirement to try to play sports in a giant restrictive form obfuscating garment. So, yay? One programming note here. If any friends or family members of the traveling women's badminton team are watching this show right now, we here at The Rachel Maddow Show would love to hear how the trip went when the team comes home. And on this show, obviously, you can wear whatever you want.